Okay, good morning children. Today we are starting our second day. Yesterday we had completed the recurring deposit account, the theoretical aspect, and the conceptual discussions were over. And as we had told you, today we are going to deal with the problems given in the textbook. The textbook which is provided to you by the school, and we have the questions here. All the questions are here. I will show you the questions. We will read the question, then we will be solving all the questions on the blackboard itself. So you again open the computer, and at your convenience you can watch the recorded video. So this is exercise number 2. We will begin with question number 1. Here the question number 1 says, Akash deposited rupees 520 per month in a recurring deposit account for 18 months. If the rate of interest is 10% per annum, calculate the amount. I have highlighted here, calculate the amount that Akash will receive at the time of maturity. So this is what we need to understand, what we need to find, what we need to calculate. In all the questions you can see I have highlighted what we need to find. So when you also get a question paper, you first read the question well and underline the quantity that we need to find, that the question is asking you to find. So here before I start the solution, I will note down all the data or the information that is provided in the question. So this is question number 1, solution. Given here Akash deposited rupees 520 per month, so I will write, this is monthly deposit, I will write rupees 520. Rupees 520, this is given. You may write here given, or even if you don't write also, just write the variable P equal to 520. Then what is given to us? The account was held for 18 months. So here we will write N equal to 18 months. Already the duration is given in the form of months, so there is no need of converting the time. Already the time is in the form of months, and given rate equal to 10%. Rate equal to 10% here, and question is asking calculate the amount at the time of maturity. Akash will receive at the time of maturity. Its meaning is we need to calculate the maturity value. MB we need to calculate. And just recall the formula that we had learned yesterday, that was N into P plus P into N into N plus 1 by 2 into 12 into R by 100. I wrote the formula here, and then I need to substitute the values for the variables. I have already noted down the variables and their corresponding values. I need to substitute here. N is here 18 months, so N equal to 18. P is written here 520 plus 520, again here P is there 520 into N is 18, N plus 1 will be 19. So 18 into 19 divided by 2 into 12 into R is here 10, so 10 by 100. that equals, just now this is a simplification. Now I have converted this problem into a simplification problem. This is no more a recurring deposit problem because all the process is done. Now we can simplify it and we can get the result here. For quicker calculation, I am using the calculator, but remember, you will not be allowed to use the calculator in the examination hall. Here to for a quicker calculation, so that you, your time will be saved, I am using the calculator, but calculator will not be allowed in the examination. 18 into 520 9360 9360 plus, then you can do the cancellation process. You can cancel here. Here also there is one option, you can cancel, and then you can simplify the rest. 52 into 18 into 19 divided by 2 into 12, 24. The answer is 741, 741, and when we add this to 9360, we get 10101, this is the answer. This is the answer for question number 1. So just note down, then we can move to question number 2 now. So we shall move to question number 2. Question number 2 says, Venu deposited rupees 380 per month in a recurring deposit account for 2 years and 6 months. So time is given here in the form of year and months. Rate of interest is 8.5%, and I have highlighted the quantity to be calculated. That is, again, calculate the maturity value of each account. Just it is the same process as we followed in question number 1. So as I solve the problems, in case you are in front of computer, in case you are in front of your smartphone, you can also simultaneously start calculating. You can pause the video for some time and then calculate, do the solution by yourself, and then again on switch it, again you continue it to play, so that you can verify your result with the result that we have done here. In case your answer will match with this answer as is done on the blackboard, your confidence will grow. So simultaneously you also start calculating. I will just write down here the information that is provided. Again, that is, the monthly deposit is rupees 380. I write here given. Not, it is not compulsory to write given. I did write in question number solution 1, but in case you feel like writing, you can write what is given. Given P equal to rupees 380, then time equal to, that is N, I will write here N equal to 2 years and 6 months, 2 years, 6 months, 12 into 2, 24, 24 plus 6, that is 30 months, 30 months, or you can write 30. And again here, rate is 8.5%, rate is 8.5%, and we need to calculate again the maturity value here. So the solution is just like the solution number 1. We write the formula here, MA equal to N into B plus B into N into N plus 1 divided by 2 into 12 multiplied by R by 100. So we wrote the formula correctly, then we will substitute correctly and then we can do the calculation. N is here 30, so I will write 30 into P is 380 rupees, 380 plus, again substituting P here 380, our N is here 30, so N into N plus 1, that is 30 into 31 divided by 2 into 12 into R is here 8.5 divided by 100. Now again it begin a simplification problem. We will just simplify it and the result, the final answer will come out. 30 into 380 11400 plus, here whatever cancellation is necessary when you do manually, you can have the wrong one adjacent to the solution. Remember, in the examination when you do the wrong one, don't look for a separate sheet of paper. All the rough work must be done adjacent to the solution only. So whatever space will be there to the right side in your paper, you need to show the rough work to the right side only. So all the rough work related to this you need to do here, and then you will write this result in this space. Because I am using a calculator here, I am not showing the rough work here. And I directly calculate this and write the result here now. That is 380 into 30 into 31 into 8.5 divided by 12 into 2, 24 into 100, 2400. The result is 1251.625. Once again I will check because 3 digit is coming. 380 into 30 into 31 into 8.5 divided by 12 into 2, 24, 2400. So 1251.625 plus 11400, 12651.625. You can round up and write here 12651.63. So this will be the result for the answer for question number 2. Next we will move to question number 3 now, and question number 3 is not asking to find the maturity value, it is asking to find the monthly installment now. This is not maturity value, monthly installment, but our process of calculation will remain same. We will write all the data that is provided, then just calculate the unknown quantity. Question number 3 says, Charan had a recurring deposit account in a bank for 3 years at 9.5% per annum. If he gets rupees 18,159.90 as maturity value, find the monthly installment. So question has already given N value, the rate of interest and the maturity value, and P is missing. So I will put here one question mark, P is missing, and N I will write N equal to 3 years, but I will take it as months, that is 36 months. Then R is taken here, R is given here 9.5%. And MB already given. Maturity value is already given 18159.90. So here what I need to do is I will just write the formula for maturity value and I will write one equation, MB formula, N into P plus P into N plus 1 by 2 into 12 into R by 100 equal to 18159.90, and then I will go for substitution of the remaining variables, because already I have substituted MB value, already I have put. I will substitute the value of N 36. P value is not known, so I will put here P only. Here P value is not known, I will put P only. N value is 36, so 36 into 37 divided by 2 into 12 into R value is 9.5, so 9.5 divided by 100 equal to 18159.90. So now this is a simple equation. It is a linear equation because it involves only one variable. Solving linear equation, we have a lot of experience of solving linear equation in one variable. Now once we solve this equation, we will get the required answer. So here 36 into P, that will give 36P plus, here whatever simplification is possible you can do when you do manually on your copy. I multiply here directly 36 into 37 into 9.5. I get here 12654 P divided by 2400 equal to 18159.90. I get the LCM here 2400, 36 P by 1, 36 into 2400 2400. 2400 into 36. 86400. P plus 12654 P equal to 18159.90. 86400 plus 12654 P. 12685 86400 plus 12654 99054 P equal to, I can cross multiply here, 18159.90 into 2400. 99054 P equal to 18159.90 into 2400. Or you can just write without multiplying also, 18159.90 into 2400. And here what you can do, instead of this, you can just write P here, and this you can transpose, 99054. That will give the value of P divided by 99054. We get the answer 430. So the person deposited rupees 430 every month. That is the monthly installment. Find the monthly installment. This is the solution for question number 3. We can go to question number 4. I feel question number 4 can be given to you. You can try it, because question number 4 is also asking find the monthly installment. Dinesh had a recurring deposit account in a bank for 20 months. So time N is given 20. At 8% per annum, rate is given 8% per annum. Maturity value is also given 13482. Find again the monthly installment. I hope you can follow the solution for question number 3, and you can try it by yourself. In case you have difficulty, we can discuss it when you come to the class for the regular classes during the face-to-face interaction. Question number 4, find monthly installment. Question number 5, find monthly installment. So question number 4 and question number 5, I leave it to you, do it at home, follow the solution of question number 3. I will move to the question number 6, because question number 6 is different from question 1 to 5. Question number 5 is asking us to find the rate of interest, because it is a different type of question. Let us read the question and understand. David opened a recurring deposit account in a bank and deposited rupees 300 per month for 2 years. If he received rupees 7725 at the time of maturity, he received 7725 at the time of maturity. Question has not specified the 7725 he received as maturity value, or he received this amount 7725 as interest. So here we have to work under the assumption, we have to assume that 7725 will be the maturity value. Under that assumption we have to calculate the rate of interest. Now we will move to question number 6 here. Question number 6. Given monthly deposit P equal to rupees 300. Then it is given time is 2 years, so I will write N equal to 2 years, that is 24 months. And then maturity value equal to ₹7725 and rate, this is the question mark here. We have to calculate the rate. Again I will write MV equal to 7725 and I will write the formula for the maturity value now. Maturity value formula, N into P plus N in, sorry, P into N into N plus 1 by 2 into 12 into R by 100 equal to 7725. And now we need to substitute the values which are given to us. Values given to us, N value given, so 24. P value is given here 300. 24 into 300. Again, P value is given here 300. N value is given 24. So 24 into 25 divided by 2 into 12. Into R by 100, R is not known, we need to calculate. So instead of R, I just wrote R here, 7725. Now, this is also a simple linear equation in one variable. And once we solve the linear equation in one variable, the required quantity, that is rate of interest, will come out. So here 24 into 300, 24 into 300, 24 into 300, 7200, 7200 plus, we can do some cancellation work here, it is easy, 12 into 2, 24, 12 into 2, 24. Also we can do a very simple simplification here, 100 and here 3, because what will be easy now, 3 into 25, that is 75R, 75R, that is 7725. Now 75R equal to 7725 minus 7200, transposition method we applied, transpose the quantity to right side, 75R equal to, how much we will get, 525, then R equal to 525 divided by 75. 525 divided by 75, and that will give the answer 7%. Rate of interest is 7%. So this is also a very easy solution. There is nothing hard here. There is no difficulty involved here. Write the quantities which are given and then write the formula to calculate the maturity value and then substitute all the variables with the values which are given and then you solve the equation. So here question number 6 is over. Question number 6 was asking find the rate of interest per annum. We got it. And as you can see, question number 7 also. Question number 7 also, it is asking again find the rate of interest. find the rate of interest. I hope by following the solution of question number 6, you can also try for yourself question number 7 also, finding rate of interest, finding rate of interest, because one solution is already done, similar solution you try so that your confidence can grow. So now we will move to question number 8. Question number 8. Question number 8 asking us to find the maturity period. I had told you yesterday out of the 4 patterns of questions, there are 4 patterns of questions. One is to calculate the maturity value, another one is to calculate the monthly installments, the next pattern is to calculate the rate of interest, and the 4th pattern, that is to calculate the time period for which the account is held. And children, avoid that pattern. Which pattern? This particular pattern. Avoid this pattern, this question, like plague, I can tell you, like plague. And the reason is that this question, calculating the time period, calculating the time period in RD concept, recurring deposit concept, it involves a quadratic equation. It involves a quadratic equation, and sometimes the numerical coefficients of the terms of the variables are so big that on seeing the big figures, children just stop trying. Children just stop trying. I can tell you, once I was teaching in a certain batch, I don't want to mention the name of that child. I had given a problem, and in that problem I had asked the children to calculate the time period, and the children were sitting for 40 minutes and no answer was coming. Everybody has framed the equation and they are sitting, and the child who was the topper in the class, I asked, what happened dear, why are you sitting for a long time and why no answer is coming? And the child said something to me in Hindi, sir, kano se dhuan nikal jata hai, kano se dhuan nikal jata hai sir. So see, anyhow, they were trying sitting for 40 minutes, answer was not coming, and that was their response, that was their reaction. Means that way they feel about that problem, but there is nothing hard. If you follow the process properly, then this type of question also you can do very easily. Let us see how to tackle that kind of problem. Finding the maturity period. Find the maturity period of the RD accounts in each of the following cases. So this is 8 number first bit. It says monthly deposit is rupees 540. So I can write here P equal to 540. I didn't write rupee symbol here. It is understood. And rate of interest R is 6% per annum. R is 6% per annum. And then maturity value MB. MB is given 10181.70, and N value is not given. We need to calculate the value of N. So here again I will do the same thing. I will start with MB. MB equal 10181.70, and then I will write the formula for MV. M into V plus P into N plus 1 divided by 2 into 12 into R by 100 is equal to 10181.70. So the purpose is to frame one equation. The purpose is to frame one equation here, and this will not give a linear equation now. This will give us a quadratic equation, in which an equation in which highest power of the variable is 2, and we will read in greater details about quadratic equation. There is a special chapter about it, but since that quadratic equation concept is applied here, we have no other option than solving it, learning how to solve. Now I will write N into P. N is not given, P is 540, so N into 540 plus P is given here 540, so 540 N into N plus 1, I can write N square plus N, N square plus N divided by 2 into 12, 2 into 12, and into R is given 6, so 6 by 100, that equal to 10181.70. Now we can see what we can cancel, so that the coefficients of the variables in the equation will be smaller, and it will be easy for us to solve the problem, solve the equation. Here there is no way to cancel plus here. Don't think about cancelling 540 with this. You cannot cancel because here there is plus sign. In case there is multiplication sign here, this cancellation will be allowed. Here you can see there is multiplication sign, cancellation will be allowed here, but cancellation cannot be allowed because of this plus sign. So I will just write 540N plus, and I can do the cancellation here, 6 and here 2, 6 2s are 12. And here I have got 540, here I have got 100, I can reduce this, and here I got 2 into 2, 4, and here I have got 54, so 54, and here 2 into 2, 4, 54 will not go by 4, but it will go by 2, so I can cancel here and write here 27. And now I will write 27n plus 27n divided by this 2, what is left out, 2, and here what is left out, 10. So 2 into 10. Remember that here 10 is left out and here 2 is left out. 2 into 10, that is 20. That equal to 10181.70. Now I need to find the LCM here, 20, and 54 into 2, 108, and this 0 and this 0, 10800n plus 27n square plus 27n equal to 10181.70. 0.70. 27 n square I write as the first term because here power is bigger, plus 10800 plus 27 10827 n equal to multiplying 10181 into 7.7 into 20 by cross multiplication. What I get, I will write there directly 10181.7 into 20 will give us 2020 3634. And I bring it to the left side now, and right side I keep 027 n square 10827 n minus 203634 equal to 0. And now the problem begins, how to solve this. Here a 6 digit number is involved, here there is a 5 digit number, and splitting the middle term and solving the equation seems to be a difficult task. But remember that these terms can be reduced further. There is a possibility that these coefficients will be divisible by either this coefficient 27 or sometimes by some factors of 27. So I will try to see whether this 10827 and 203634 will be divisible by 27, so that my equation will be a very simple equation. 10827 divided by 27, this is divisible. When I divided 10827 by 27, I have got 401 n. And I will try again. I am trying, that is why this place I have not yet written. In case this is also divisible by 27, then I will write here 27 n square by 27. So 203634 divided by 27, and that is also divisible, 7542. And 27 n square by 27 will also give the answer n square. So my equation seems to be easier now to solve. I can solve it very easily, but still here there is a question, how to split the middle term, because still the numbers are 3 digit and 4 digit numbers. I will tell you the simple process here, how to split the middle term. Don't give up any hope, don't feel that the numbers are very big and it is very difficult. It is not so difficult. I can tell you here the numerical coefficient is not there, that means there is one invisible numerical coefficient, that is 1. So 1 into 7542, I will write here 1 into 7542. Product of these two numbers is 1 into 7542 only. Now I will try to find two numbers. I will try to find two numbers, express this product as product of two other numbers whose sum or difference will be 401. 1 into 7542 equal to 7542. Now I will say 2 into how much? 2 into how much equal to 7542? 2 into how much equal to 7542? The answer is 3771. 3771. But the sum of these two numbers, sum of these two numbers or difference of these two numbers is not going to give us 401. It is not going to give us 401. I will think about some other number, some other pair. What might be that pair? This number is also divisible by 3. So 3 into how much equal to 7542? How I know this is divisible by 3? I applied the divisibility rule of 3. Sum of the digits of a number is divisible by 3, then the number is divisible by 3. 7 plus 5, 12. 12 plus 4, 16. 16 plus 2, 18. 18 is divisible by 3. So this number is divisible by 3. That is why I have initiated here and written 3 into 7, 5, 4, 2 divided by 3. 2, 5, 1, 4. 2, 5, 1, 4. But this pair will also not give 401. Neither the sum nor the difference of the third pair is going to give us 401. So I will try for some other pair. I will see that this number is not divisible by 4, because when I applied the divisibility rule of 4, the number formed by the last two digits is not divisible by 4. So I am not going to write 4 here, because that is not a multiple of 4. This is not a multiple of 5 also, but it will be a multiple of 6, because it is divisible by both 2 and 3. So I will write here 6 now. 6 into 7542 divided by 6, and that is 1257. 1257. And this pair also doesn't serve the purpose, because neither the sum nor the difference of 6 and 1257 will give us 401. So I will again look for some other suitable pairs. Till I get a suitable pairs, I have to go on trying, and this is the only way to solve the quadratic equation by splitting the middle term. When the coefficients are very big, this is the only method. Go on doing till you get a pair. So you should not give up half the way. So now let us see by which other numbers this will be divisible. This will not be divisible by 7. We can try. It will not be divisible by 7. If it is divisible, we can take. It is not divisible by 7. This will not be divisible by even 8. It will not be divisible even by 8. But let us see whether it will be divisible by 9, because we have the divisibility rule. 7 plus 5, 12. 12 plus 4, 16. Plus 2, 18. Sum of the digits is divisible by 9. So this number is divisible by 9. 9 into how much will give 7542? Divided by 7542 divided by 9, 838, that is 7542. But unfortunately, this pair of numbers is also not serving our purpose. Again, I need to have the patience to try some more numbers, some pairs, to find some more pairs and see. This will not be divisible by 10, because last digit is not 0. Then we need to see whether it is divisible by 11. 7 plus 4, 11. 5 plus 2, 7. By applying the divisibility rule of 11, I understood it is not divisible by 11. I can try for 12. By 12, it may not be divisible. It may not be divisible by 12. The reason is that it was not divisible by 4 even. It was not divisible by 4. So, next option for me is, it will not be divisible by 13, nor by 14, because 7 is not there, nor by 16, Now by 17, I can try 18 because 9 and 2 both are there. 18 into how much? Equal to 7542. 7542. 7542 divided by 18 is giving us 419. And now we can see that this pair is serving the purpose. Because difference of these two numbers is giving us 401, and this is what we wanted. So when we go on trying, ultimately we will get a suitable pair, and that will help us to solve the equation. So I will write here n square minus 18n plus 419n minus 7542 equal to 0. That implies I can take here common, n into n minus 18 plus 419 into, I just write n minus 18. There is nothing to worry and calculate, because always contents of these two brackets will be same. Contents of these two brackets will be same, that equal to 0. That implies n minus 18 into n plus 419 equal to 0. That implies n equal to 18 or minus 419. But remember that time cannot be negative. Time cannot be negative. We have taken n as the time period. Since time period negative for minus 419 not acceptable, our answer is n equal to 18 months or 1 year and 6 months. So this is how we need to solve the problems where the problem is asking us to calculate the maturity period or the time period for which an account is held. So the only way to split the middle term is to go on trying this way till we get a suitable pair, and then we will be able to solve it. So there are 4 problems here. Even if all the problems you can do in the same method, but the problem occurs in this step, how to split the middle term. How to split the middle term, that is why I don't want to leave it to you and give as homework. I will be solving all these 4 numbers for you. So first bit is over. Now we will be moving to the second bit of question number 8. Question number 8, second bit. As you can see in the question, monthly deposit is rupees 280, rate of interest 9.5%, maturity value 10130.40. So I can write here, given P equal to rupees 280, again I didn't write the rupee symbol because it is understood, rate of interest is 9.5%, and maturity value is given 10130.40, and time is, n is again a question mark, that is the unknown quantity. Again I will start with MB to frame the equation. MB equal to 10130.40. That implies n into p plus p into n into n plus 1 by 2 into 12 into R by 100 equal to 101130.40. Now we will substitute the values which are given to us in the question. N is not given, P is given, so I will write here N into 280 plus P is here 280 into N into N square plus N by 2 into 12 into R is given 9.5 divided by 100 101130.40. We can write here 280N plus, I can do some cancellation here, 280 here 10, here 10 I can cancel to make my work easier. Again, what else I can cancel? Here there is 28 and here 2 into 12. 28 will be divided by 4. So I can cancel here 4 7 and here 4 3 4 3 jar. And now I will write here 7 into N square plus N by 2 into 3, 6. And there what I can do, 9.5 will give 95 by 10 and into 10, into 10, that is 101130.40. So that further I can cancel here, this can go by 5, 19 jar and here 5, 2 jar. So that the coefficients of the equation will be very smaller. Okay, coefficients will be smaller. Now I can write here 280N plus, here what is left out, 19 into 7, 133 into N square plus N divided by 10 into 2, 20, 20 into 6, 120 equal to 101130.40. We can find the LCM now here. LCM is 120 into 280, that will give us 33600 N plus 133 N square plus 133 N equal to 101130.40. 133 N square I will be writing as the first term again. 133 N square plus sum of these two, 33600 plus 133 33733 equals product of these two by cross multiplication. Product of these two 10130.4 into 120. 1215 648. Sorry, here n I should write 133 n² plus 337 33 n minus 1215 648 equal to 0. So here again, by seeing the numbers consisting of 4 digits and 5 digits, don't give up your hope, don't get frightened. Try to reduce this. As I have told you, these coefficients, this coefficient and this constant may be divided by some of the factors of this coefficient. This is 133. It is product of 19 and 7. 19 and 7. Because we got here 19 and 7, product is 133. So these numbers may be divided by 19, may be divided by 7. So we can try here 33733 is divided by 7. Yes. 1215648 33733 divided by 7 I had got the result 4819. Here when divided by 7 I got 4819, and on dividing the constant 1215648 by 7, I also get a number which is perfectly divisible, 173 663 664 664. So here I get now complete it, and here I will write this divided by 7, 19 n square. Now further I will try whether this is divided by 19 or not. I will try 4819 divided by 19. It is not going to be divisible. So the only option left is I need to now split the middle term. I need to split the middle term by using the same process as we had done for the first bit. But you need to have a lot of patience. Don't try to jump to the answer directly. There is no shortcut. You have to follow the process. You have to follow the process with patience. I will again write here 19 into 173 664 664. Even if you don't write this answer, even if you don't write this answer here, there is no problem here at all. There is no need to find the product actually. But what we need to do is, you see, this number is divisible by 2. So divide this by 2 and multiply this by 2. 19 into 2, 38. And 173664. 173664 divided by 2. 86832. 86832. This pair is not going to give us 4819. Now again I will see. this number is again divisible by 2. So I will multiply 38 into 2 will give 76. 76. Then 86832. 86832 divided by 2 will give 43416. 43416. Yes. So this is not so hard. Again I can see last digit is here 6. Again this is going to be divisible by 2. So I will multiply this by 2 further. 2 6 are 12. 2 7 are 14 plus 1 15. 152. I multiplied this by 2. I will divide it by 2 now. Divided by 2. 2 1 7 0 8. Yes, again 1 seems to be easier because here again there is 8. And this pair is not going to give us 4819 because it is 21,000 and this is only 152. Their difference is not going to be nearer to 4000. So I will again multiply this by 2. So I will get here 2 2 are 4, 2 5 are 10, 2 1 are 2 plus 1 3. And I will divide this by again 2. Dividing this by 2, I got 10,854. 854. And this pair is also not going to give me 4819. Their difference or sum is not anywhere nearer to 4819. I will again proceed further. Multiply this by 2, that is 608. 608. And divide 10854 by 2, I got 5427. 5427. And now I feel that this difference of these two numbers is somewhere nearer to 4819. Because one is 5000 something, another one 600 something. Find the difference. 5427 minus 608. 5427 minus 608 is giving exactly 4819. And this is how you need to tackle the problems which are asking you to find the time period. So I can now write here 19n square minus 608n plus 5427 n minus 173664, that equals 0. That implies I can take here 19 common, 19 I can take common, then 608 divided by 19 will give me 32, will give me 32 here, plus I can take this fully common because only in the bracket n minus 32 should be left because contents of both the bracket must be same. So n will be left here alone means 5427 must be taken common. And 5427 into 32, I will check. 5427 into 32 is giving exactly 173664. So I am just arriving at the last step of the solution. And here I got n minus 32 into 19n plus 5427 equal to 0. Equal to 0. And again I get here 10 equal to 32, n equal to 32, or n will be minus 5427 minus 5427 by 19, but this is not acceptable. It is not acceptable because it is negative number, So the time period is 32 months. The time period, the answer for the second period is 32 months. So this is how we need to solve the problem based on time period, calculating the maturity period. There are two more problems here, calculating the maturity period or the time period. Monthly deposit is given, then monthly rate of interest is given, maturity value is given. So these two problems and the remaining, the question number 9, 10 and 11, and we will be discussing in the classes tomorrow. In case you are interested to try it at home, you may try, but anyhow I will be solving these two problems again tomorrow in the class, and then we will see what problems are there in question number 9, 10 and 11. So I hope whatever we did today you have understood, and when we are writing things on the blackboard, sometimes I may make mistake while writing some digits, because when I teach and I concentrate this side, maybe due to some distraction what is there here and there, sometimes somewhere some digits I may leave, sometimes I may make some mistake. In case you notice something during this lessons and all, you may also notify it through the YouTube, because there are options to give the remarks and all. So you please bring it to my notice so that I can see that part again and tell you and rectify the thing. So have a nice day once again, and again take care of your health, yourself and your elders, other family members in your family, and thank you.